Good morning. So let us start with our part 4 of solution. Hope all of you are fine. Hope all of you are in good health. So let us start our part 4 of solution. So in the last class we have seen Raoult's law for the case where we have a volatile solute and we have a volatile solvent also. Right. We have checked for the case of volatile solute and solvent how the vapor pressure changes. Now today we will go more in depth into the chapter and we will look that it always we will not have two components volatile. Right. Volatile, what is volatile? Volatiles are those components that escape easily, right? But in all the cases, we will not have all the components volatile. We will put non-volatiles be hamemilya. And when we will have non-volatile things, the things is going to change. So, before going into this, let us see the first property. Let us see a very interesting property, that is the colligative properties. Let us see the colligative properties. See. What are colligative properties? So the physical property of the solution, which depends upon the number of the particles. See, there are certain properties which only depends upon the number of the particles, depends upon the quantity of the particles. These particles does not depend upon the nature, upon their nature, in the reactivity. In some way, yeah, properties depend nahi ho rahe. Right. These are the properties that depends only how many are present here. Right. Suppose for example, in a classroom, kitna branches ho rahe. The number of benches, the number of desks, the number of chairs, kitna chairs hoga, ye kis pe depend karega? Ye depend karega ki number of students kitne hai. Similarly, there are some properties that depends only on the number of particles. Right, and these properties are known as colligative properties. We will study these colligative properties one by one in details. So, it will be very interesting things today we are going to learn. So, let's fly. See, these are the four colligative properties we are going to learn. First, we are going to learn lowering of vapor pressure. After the lowering of vapor pressure, we are going to learn about the elevation in boiling point. Then we are going to learn about depression in freezing point. And at last, we will learn about the osmotic pressure. In today's class, we will cover these two. In the upcoming class, we will cover these two. And in there another one or two class, we will be concluding this chapter. So three more class means and we will be concluding our solution chapter. And whatever notes I have given you, this will be sufficient for your board exam. As well as it will be very helpful for competitive exam. We will solve some more questions in the class for the competitive exam. So we need to solve it in the moment. So see, colligative properties. Now what are the colligative properties? As we say that it only depends upon the number of the particles. A number of the particles is again what? It is directly proportional to the number of the moles. Number of the moles is again related to mole fraction, number of ions and number of molecules. So colligative property is directly proportional to number of particles. Colligative property is directly proportional to number of molecules. Colligative property is directly proportional to number of ions. It is directly proportional to number of moles and it is directly proportional to mole fraction of the solute. So let us begin our journey of colligative property with lowering of vapor pressure. With lowering of vapor pressure. So, are you ready? So, let's begin our journey with lowering of vapor pressure. See. See the interesting thing. Look at this one. Suppose we have a pure solvent. We have a pure solvent. Water. Pure. Bilkul akela present hai water. Koi nahi hai uske saath. Suppose we have on a pure solvent. Water in it. Right. Suppose we have a pure solvent. Water in it. हमारे पास प्योर सॉल्वेंट है कौन सा प्योर सॉल्वेंट है हमारे पास वी हैव ए प्योर सॉल्वेंट वाटर राइट वी हैव ए प्योर सॉल्वेंट वाटर ओके ठीक है अभी नाउ द थिंग इज दैट इट हैज अ सर्टेन वेपर प्रेशर जब वो अकेला अकेला होगा वाटर व्हेन इट इज ऑल अलोन देन आल्सो इट विल हैव अ सर्टेन वेपर प्रेशर देन विल आल्सो इट हैव अ सर्टेन वेपर प्रेशर लेट इट हैज अ वेपर प्रेशर पी Let it have a vapor pressure P. Right. Now, when we are adding some non-volatile solute in, that is pure nahi rahega because we are adding something in it, so it will be no longer pure. So we are adding something. Definitely, whatever we add, we call it what? We call it solute. And if somebody don't know what is vapor pressure, please go to my previous video and see what is vapor pressure. We have discussed in details about vapor pressure. We have done the numericals of vapor pressure also. So, whenever we are adding something, what we call it what? Solute. Now the very interesting thing is that when we are adding solute in the solvent, when we are adding non-volatile solute in the solvent, what will happen? The very interesting thing happens. Whatever the vapor pressure the solvent has, this vapor pressure gets reduced. This vapor pressure gets reduced. Now why? Because समझना होगा ना कि वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू मग अप द थिंग्स एवरीथिंग राइट सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई दिस थिंग इज हैपनिंग सी सपोज वी हैव अ कंटेनर अर्लियर सपोज इन द सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल्स इट हैज ओनली पहले समझते हैं सरफेस में सिर्फ ए मॉलिक्यूल था प्योर और कोई नहीं था प्योर ए इज देयर Correct? These are the molecules which are involved in creating the vapor pressure, right? Now here we are adding some non-volatile solute B. अब क्या होगा ना? What will happen? See the interesting thing, what will happen now? Some of the space of the surface. Surface mein jo pehle kya tha? Pehle surface mein sirf A tha, only A is there in the surface. But now the things will change. In surface, now we will not have only A. Along with A, we will have B also. And some of the A molecules which are initially present in the surface are now no longer on the surface, they go down. अब क्या होगा देखो B खुद तो बाहर नहीं जाएगा vapor pressure create करने के लिए B will not go to create the vapor pressure. Why? Because B is a non-volatile solute. It will not allow even A to go out. Right. B will not go by itself. And it will not allow even A to go out. So, ab kya hoga na? What will happen? B So earlier the vapor pressure is due to some of the molecules of air. Now the vapor pressure, अभी जो vapor pressure होगा वो कम जाएगा because now less number of surface molecules will be involved because some of the surface is occupied by a non-volatile being. And since some of the space is occupied by a non-volatile being, now some of the space is occupied by a non-volatile being. So what happens? The vapor pressure decreases. The vapor pressure, क्या हो जाएगा vapor pressure? The vapor pressure decreases. The vapor pressure decreases. Isn't it? The vapor pressure will what? The vapor pressure will decrease. Now, see. If at a certain temperature, कोई भी एक temperature हो, if at a certain temperature, suppose P is the pressure of the pure solvent. Right? And PS is the vapor pressure of the solution. मतलब क्या है? At first, it has a vapor pressure P. And after that, we add some non-volatile solute. So, just now we have seen, whenever we will be adding some non-volatile solute, whenever we are adding some non-volatile solute, what will happen? Kya hoga? Whenever we are adding some non-volatile solute, what will happen? What will happen whenever we are adding some non-volatile solute? Whenever we are adding some non-volatile solute, vapor pressure jo hai, vapor pressure kam jayega. The vapor pressure will decrease. So suppose now the new vapor pressure becomes PS. And obviously the PS will be what? PS will be smaller than P. Obviously the PS will be smaller than P. Right? Very good. Samajh mein aaya sabko? Okay. And now we know this from the last class. This is the equation we have derived in the last video. So those who have not seen, please see this video how this is coming. This is the theme of relative lowering of what? Vapor pressure. What is Na? What is Na? Na kya hai? Batao zara. Number of moles of A. Right? What is Nb? Number of moles of A. This is actually what? This is actually shy. Sorry, zeta. Correct? Koi ki usko x se bhi bolta hai, but it is zeta. Now see. You consider that the solution is a dilute solution. We consider that the solution is a dilute solution. So, what does dilute solution mean? Dilute solution ka matlab kya hota hai? Just see. Dilute solution is the solution where the quantity of solute is very, very less. Right? More the dilute solution, lesser is the quantity of the solute. Lesser is the quantity of the solute. Quantity of solution kam ho jayega. Lesser is the quantity of the solution. So, lesser is the quantity of the solute in the solution. Lesser is the quantity of the solute in the solution. So let us consider a very dilute solution. Matlab number of solute jo hoga solution mein, it will be extremely what? It will be extremely small. And since it will be extremely small, we can neglect the value of Na. We can neglect the value of Na. So we have come to this equation. And this is what? P naught minus P. This is difference. This is the partial pressure in the pure state. This is the partial pressure in the solution. And this is what? Difference in pressure we can write. This is what? P naught. This is what? P naught minus Ps by P naught. Correct. And this is what? Na by N. Now this del P by P naught. You say this is Na by Nb. So, we can also say the relative lowering of vapor pressure is this one. This is del P, P naught minus Ps. This is what P naught and this is what relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure is what? Na by Wb. What is Na? What is Na? Number of moles of A. What is number of moles of A? Number of moles of A kya hai? Given mass by of A by molecular mass of A. And what is Nb? What is Nb? Nb is also number of moles of B by molecular mass of B. Since it is divided, so we multiply the change of that. Samajh mein, is it clear to all of you? Moving ahead. Let's solve the numerical problem. See. Calculate the vapor pressure lowering. So we have to calculate the vapor pressure lowering. Calculate the vapor pressure lowering. So kya calculate karna hai hame? We need to calculate del P. Okay. We have given 50 gram of sucrose. We have given 50 gram of sucrose. Correct? We have 50 gram of sucrose. So given mass of solute is 50 gram. दिमाग में आप लोगों का आ गया होगा गिवन मास है अगर 50 ग्राम तो मॉलिक्यूलर मास क्या होगा व्हाट विल बी द मॉलिक्यूलर मास 342 नाउ सी इन योर बोर्ड एग्जाम मोस्ट ऑफ द केसेस मॉलिक्यूलर मास विल बी गिवन बट इन योर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम वी हैव टू नो द मॉलिक्यूलर मास मींस वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द मॉलिक्यूलर मास एंड आई हैव गिवन अ लिस्ट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर जेईई एंड एनडब्ल्यू राइट इन योर फर्स्ट क्लास प्लीज चेक दिस अब देखो यहाँ पे क्या है नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सुक्रोज जैसे ही देखा व्हेनेवर यू सी दिस 50 ग्राम ऑफ सुक्रोज यू सी हैव इजीली कैलकुलेटेड द नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सुक्रोज करेक्ट नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ सुक्रोज इज नोन टू अस नाउ हियर इट वाज नॉट मेंशन दैट वेदर इट इज अ वेरी डाइल्यूट सॉल्यूशन और इट इज अ नॉन डाइल्यूट सॉल्यूशन सो एज लॉन्ग एज द थिंग इज नॉट मेंशन टू यू that whether it is a dilute solution or it is a non dilute solution we will consider it as a we will take it as a dilute solution sorry we will take it as not so dilute solution we will take it as a normal solution ki jaise usko treat karna hai normal solution jaisa usko treat karna hai okay now come back to the Raoult's formula this what we need to calculate this what we need to calculate so we are writing here del p because we need to calculate this one, a P naught, most of the time, cross multiply, it will be what? P naught. It will be P naught. So this is number of moles of solvent. What is the number of moles of solvent here? Given mass of water by molecular mass. Given mass is here given, 500 gram. So lucky you are. So this is the molecular mass of water, ratio 18. And you have found out. P naught, in the pure state, in the pure state, is given, see, in the pure water is written here. So, now the numericals is very easy to you. You just put the value and you will get your answer. Okay, moving ahead. Let's move. Let us move to our next topic. Elevation in boiling point. Understand it very, very carefully. See, समझो चीजों को. जो जस्ट तभी तो मजा आएगा. See. What is boiling point? What is the definition of boiling point? What is the definition of boiling point? We say that the boiling point of water is 100 degrees centigrade. Correct? The boiling point of water is 100 degrees centigrade. Boiling point of water is 100 degrees centigrade. But is it that all the liquid has same boiling point? Is the boiling point of alcohol same? Is the boiling point of other liquids same? Nahi hai same. All the boiling point is not same. Right, the boiling point of the different liquids is different. The boiling point of the different liquid is different. Right, all the boiling point is not same. The boiling point of the different liquid is different. And why is? What is the meaning of that line? It's the significance here. What is the meaning of that line? That water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. What is the significance of this line that water boils at 100 degrees? Water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. What is the significance of this? The significance of this is that at 100 degrees centigrade, anything boiling point of a liquid is that particular point at which the pressure becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. At which the pressure becomes equal to the atmospheric pressure. आप समझना जरा आराम से nothing. Okay. Now when suppose this is a pure solvent. Suppose this is a pure solvent. Correct? It has a certain boiling point. Suppose let us consider water. So the boiling point is 100 degrees centigrade. Means at 100 degrees centigrade, the boiling point of water will reach that mark. Will reach that mark. मतलब वो water atmosphere हो जाएगा. It will become one atmospheric pressure, right? Now we are adding the non-volatile solute. जब हम इसमें non-volatile solute डाल रहे हैं, what will happen? Whatever vapor pressure it has, so it will become lower. It will become what? Vapor pressure will decrease. Since vapor pressure will further decrease, vapor pressure पहले जितना था उससे भी कम जाएगा, तो होगा क्या? We need more amount of it. So that it can reach the atmospheric pressure. That is why when we add a non-volatile solute, there we see the There we see the increase in the boiling point, that is elevation in the boiling point we see. I hope it is very clear to you now. See, when a non-volatile solute is dissolved in a pure solvent, the vapor pressure is decreased. Correct? And the difference if the boiling point of the solution after adding non-volatile solute, right? There will be change from that of the pure solvent. Change means it will increase from that of the pure solvent, and this is known as elevation in boiling point. Now this derivation is actually not that much important from exam boardism point of view, and neither the derivation is asked in the exercise, but still I have done this derivation for you. You see? See. If T0 is the boiling point of pure solvent, suppose this is the boiling point of pure solvent. Now this is the pure solvent. Now what I have said? Jab hum log non-volatile solute add karenge to kya hoga? The boiling point increases. So suppose this is the boiling point of solution. And the boiling point of solution will be always greater than the boiling point of pure solution. Correct? Now what is the difference in the boiling point? It will be always this minus this because it is greater. Correct? Right. And again we have seen that this is related with this one, P0 minus Ps. And P0 minus Ps is what? P0 minus Ps is del P. And del P is again related to Na by Nb. And what is Na? You just put the value of Na and Nb, you will come to this particular conclusion. Correct. Very easy this one. Oh, okay. You can do it. Should I do? You can do it by yourself. No problem. Now, for a solvent, P0, right, for a particular solvent, this is what? This is constant. So, del V is directly proportional to this one, and there we are using a constant K, and this constant K is known as an elevation constant. This constant K is known as elevation constant. Now, suppose this W by W become 1s and this W become 100 grams, correct? Everything becomes 1, then what? This K will become 2 delta. Just see here. See here. Right. Here if you take this as a 1 and the whole thing as a 1, then this will become K is equal to delta. Right? We have done this kind of derivation also. Okay. So this is the formula. This is actually the relationship. This is actually the relationship which we will be using in solving the numerical problems, the relationship between the elevation in boiling point and the molecular mass. Also, it is related in terms of molality. It is related in terms of molality. Extremely important from any competitive exam, for any competitive exam. This part is extremely important for any competitive exam. See, this we just now we have derived. If you remember from our first class, what is molality? Molality kya tha bol bata udara, what is molality? If you remember from our first class, what is molality? What is molality? What is molality? Molality is the number of moles of the solute. Correct. Molality is the number of moles of the solute dissolved in what? Dissolved in 1000 gram of the solvent. Dissolved in 1000 gram of the solvent. See this. This is what? This is what? This particular part, you see? This is exactly the formula of what? Molality. So here we are putting molality in K. That means our elevation in boiling point is directly related to molality, and we can convert one another. Correct? So let's. Okay, this is another important relationship which I want you to know. Our molar elevation constant Kb. In some of the numerical problems, we need to find out this Kb. And how we will find out this Kb? We will find out Kb by using this relationship. RTb square into Lb. RTb square into Lb. What is R? R is a molar gas constant. What is Tb? Tb is the boiling point of the solvent on Kelvin scale. And what is LV? LV is the latent heat of vaporization. LV is the latent heat of vaporization. आपको ये बोलेगा कि latent heat of vaporization क्या है, तो वो बताएगा. What is latent heat of vaporization? What do you mean by the latent heat of vaporization? Latent heat of vaporization is the amount of heat required, right? Is the amount of heat required to convert 1 kg of liquid into gases without changing its temperature. Without changing its temperature. अब temperature चेंज नहीं होगा तो heat का क्या होगा? What the heat will do? Here the heat will be used up to breaking the intermolecular force of attraction that is present in liquid. This is the sum of the values of Kb, right? Now, these are the sum values of Kb, which if you know, it can solve you in some numerical problems. There will be some numerical problems where Kb is not given. Then we will use this formula and we will find the Kb. But these are the most common solvent that comes in the question paper, so I will insist for it. Right. It's up to you. See, if you think that marking other things is very difficult, don't mark it, find in the, calculate this in the exam and find the value of Kb. But if you think that you want to do this very, very quickly, and you can, you are very good at marking other things, then you can. See. This is one of the questions. 0.15 gram of the substance is dissolved in 15 gram of solvent. Boil at a temperature, this one. What is the molecular weight of the substance? So you have to calculate the molecular weight of the substance. You have to calculate the molecular weight of the substance, right? That means what? We need to calculate this small w. Small m. We need to calculate this small m. This is our formula. This is elevation in boiling point. It is given C. Higher by this one. This means the change in boiling point is given 0.2516. Correct. Then it was, you can see here, 0.15 gram of a substance is dissolved. Right. So the given mass of solute is 0.15 gram. Right. Molecular mass we need to calculate. This is the given mass of, this is the given mass of solvent. And you see it is given 15 gram of solvent. So you just put it at 15. Right, into 1000 into Kb, you just put there in the formula, you can easily find out the molecule. This type of numericals are the easiest. This numerical problem of colligative property is very easy. It's very scoring. But only thing is that you just need to know the formula and you apply it correctly. That's it. Here you again, the rise in boiling point of a solution containing 1.8 gram of glucose is this much. Correct? That means we know the value of delta T, we know the value of the given mass of solute, that is small w, we know. The molar elevation, now we need to find out where you see the molar elevation constant of liquid. We don't know liquid. Yahan pe hame liquid kya maloom nahi. So we have to calculate the molar elevation constant of the liquid. So here Kb, that's what we need to calculate. Delta T is given. All other things are given, you just put the value, you will get your answer. So thank you for today's class. In the next class, we will be doing the other two topics.